Alright, battle against Pigeon here. I lead with Starmie and they lead with Swampert. And I go for the Grass Knot here, thinking it might stay in. But Tyranitar comes in, and at first I thought, oh, this is pretty good, because I know I can 2-hit KO it. But then I thought, oh, it's probably Scarfed. And I was scared to go for Pursuit, so I stayed in. But it goes for the Crunch, and definitely KO's. So, 6-5 down, right from the start. It's just the lead, but still a bit of a loss. So I bring in my Hitmontop, hoping I could just Mach Punch it, but Celebi comes out, and I have Heracross for Celebi, but I didn't want to bring it in because I was scared of the T-Wave here. So I go into my Bronzong here, just hoping to set up some rocks, and they go for the Leech Seed, but it misses. And I wasn't sure what this Celebi was. I was hoping it wasn't one of the Sub-Seeders, but it was. So I go for the Starter Rocks here, and I wasn't sure how to take this down because I knew the Jarrow Ball wouldn't break this up. So I go into Weezing, hoping it didn't have Psychic, and hoping it had Grass Knot instead. And I was pretty sure it would, but unfortunately for me, it did have Psychic, and you know, so I stuffed up right at the start of the battle, and you know, around here I thought I'm already lost. May as well just play around and see what happens. But I go for the Flamethrower and it does break the Psychic, and I just survived the Psychic, which is good. And I'm gonna leave it in so that it get KO'd. 6-4 right away. Wasn't very good. And we're already on the back foot. So I decide, well, I have to do something here. I can't just sit around and wait to be finished off. So I bring in Heracross going for the Mega Horn, and Rotom the Cut form comes in. And at this point I thought, well, it's all or nothing right now. I can switch and then it just gives them a chance to set up, or I can stay in and do something. And I go for the Mega Horn again, hoping that I get the Will-O-Wisp to get burned to KO it, and I did, which was nice. I mean, in Sandstorm it probably hurts a little more than it usually would, but it's good for that boost. And I decided just to go to Mega Horn again, which would definitely KO. So we get something back, but at this point I still thought, oh, we're pretty much done. It doesn't matter at this point. So I wasn't sure what had come in here, but a Heatran comes in, and I know I'm completely walled. So I go into my Hitmontop, hoping he could live one Fire Blast, and just hit back with a Mach Punch. And he did live, just. So I went for the Mach Punch. I was hoping Celebi wouldn't come out, but I was pretty sure it would, and it did. So Mach Punch does pretty much nothing. And now it's down to 5-3, so still in a bad position at this point. But we still have Raikou, Bronzong, and Heracross to go. And I go for the Carmine here, hoping it would switch. But they go for the Psychic, and I don't think they expected the Shadow Ball. But you know, that was good. I was able to get rid of Celebi, which would have caused the pain later on. And now it's 4-3, evening it up a tiny bit, but we're still on the back foot. And Tyranitar comes in, and I just switched out, thinking, oh, it wouldn't pursue me, because it didn't pursue me last time. I went to Bronzong, they go for the Stone Edge, which was a bit funny. I thought it was going to go for a Crunch, but I'm happy with the Stone Edge. So here I thought, well, if I Jarrow Ball, or Earthquake would KO it either way. But Earthquake could KO Heatran if Heatran comes in. So I go for the Earthquake, and Heatran does come in, which is very good. And I even it up to 3-3 now. So the battle's back on my foot again. And at this point, I actually thought we did have a chance to win this. So, you know, we fought back from a bad position. Jirachi comes in, and I was really hoping it wouldn't trick me. So I stayed in and went for the Earthquake, and Body Slam didn't paralyze, which it's good and bad. Would have helped Jarrow Ball, but Earthquake does over half damage, which is amazing, you know. So really good. But they switch out, obviously not wanting Jirachi to be KO'd and going to Swampert. I wasn't sure what to do here. I could explode and get rid of Swampert straight away, but I decided I'll go into Raikou because it won't earthquake and just hope that he predicts a hidden power grass and switches. So I go for the Thunderbolt here, hoping that he'd switch. I think he's seen my Raikou before, but he doesn't. He goes for the Roar instead, which really saved me, because if he had gone for the Earthquake, I would have been beaten right there. And Bronzong comes back in, and at this point, I still wasn't sure if I should Earthquake or not, or explode, and I decided to go for the Earthquake, just in case. And Jirachi does come back in, which is very good. So I'm able just to KO the Jirachi. And it's 3-2 at this point, so we're actually in the lead, and it's Swampert and Tyranitar up against Bronzong. So I just thought I may as well explode here, because Heracross will be able to take out both at, you know, at low health. And Earth Explosion does pretty good damage, doesn't KO, didn't expect it to though. And I'm going to send in Heracross here and just finish off Swampert and Tyranitar. And, you know, it's a good battle. I mean, I haven't battled much in recent times, so it's always good to battle. And, you know, I thought, oh, we're stuffed here. So, I was thinking of making a new team while this battle was going on. But, you know, eventually things went our way and a win. It's very good. I should be posting more battles in the future, hopefully. I'm not sure how many, because I have things to do, but be on the lookout, and thanks, see ya.